here is this television, sharp of course, you can see. We are going to repair this, we are attempting repair. Our minimum troubleshooting we will perform, maybe repair we will not do, but I will show the fault and troubleshooting. The problem with this one is nothing, but small problem is there, we will repair that. And now you can see in my hand the remote is, I'm commanding from the remote, so you can see. If I will command from remote, it is doing almost everything. It is changing the channel. Almost everything it is doing from the remote control. And the volume control also, I'm going to change. You can see it is changing. But if I will go to the front panel, as you can see now by my finger, I'm changing from the front panel, the channel, the volume. Nothing is performed, and the picture also. Nothing is performed by the front panel, so I will check it. I will check what is bad with this one. So I will troubleshoot it, and probably I will show how to troubleshoot this and how to find the fault in this TV set. We are going to remove all five screws. For this television rear cover to open it. I already loosened them up to save some time. This one is important. See this one? This one. Because most people have no idea about this one, the new people especially, not the older. Here is the fourth one, and here. This one is the first one. I'm going to remove this. Keep them all side, because later on, while we will fix the cover, we will fix them all. So we are going to pry the cover, pry it off, and you can see the interior. It's way dirty, way dusty. And this is not something amazing. The televisions are in the same condition. We will clean them up. We will clean this up later on. So what is bad with this one? We can see. First we will make a visual inspection on this one. So when we are making a visual inspection, it is okay. The switches are pressing. As I can listen them. As well as I can see them. So we are going to remove this chassis from, and for this purpose we have to remove some cables. As you can see, this is a speaker cable. If we will remove it from here, this will be better. And also degaussing, we are going to remove this plug. And we should have to keep it in our mind what we are going to remove. We will fix them same as we are going to remove them. So by this way, this chassis removed. As you can see, this chassis has been removed from. The angle of the camera will not be that accurate. What I'm going to do is, okay, now I'm going to show you the switches. These are the press switches actually, which I was talking about. These are all four switches which were defective. So what is defective here, we are going to check it. So it's easy to check these switches. The way is, we should have to grab our multimeter. We will put it on the continuity and should be listening for the continuity while pressing on the switch. We should have to listen it. Maybe we will get some idea. I'm going to press on one switch. It is giving response, but very tight. Other switch I have to check. other is also the same way, but easy pressing they are not coming to, gentle press they are not going to accept. So this one also I have to check. A gentle press they are not accepting. So what is the way to check it? We should have to make jump ring over here. We will make a jumper over here and then we'll see for the response. If the response is there by the jump ring, so then we will remove all these four switches, we'll replace with new switches. This will be the way to repair this. I'm going to jumper them and we'll show you the result. So I'm going to use this jumper, as this is a loop of wire you can say, and I will press, I will touch this jumper wire on the switch terminals like this, and then we'll show you the result on the television screen. So I am focusing my camera on the television screen. As you saw, the volume control had been come while I was touching to the pads or whatever the PCB. While I was touching on these switches, I was shorting with a jumper on these switches. So you saw that the volume control was functioning. So everything is okay except these switches. So I will go to replace these switches with new one. We are going to remove this, these switches, all five switches we are going to remove. Just one I am going to show you how to. So here is the switch with the soldering iron, heating up the two legs of the switch. Just removed it. You can see this one. We are going to test it, and the new one also I will test and will show you on the continuity range. Meter set to continuity. These two legs I am going to connect the meter probes with. There is no continuity while pressing on the switch. Even the continuity is not coming. You can see the switch is pressing but the continuity is not there. So if I will press very hard, then maybe the continuity will come, something like this. But with a gentle press there is no continuity. So these switches were bad, that's why the channel and the volume was not working. I am going to show you the new switch, how it is behaving. So this is a new switch, just see how it is behaving. With a little press, even with a gentle press, the continuity is there. So this is a good switch, that's why it is. So now is the time to fix this switch on the in the PCB. These legs are a little bit wider, so I'm going to cut it, they will not go to the PCB. I will cut it and later on we will cut further while it will be fixed. So here just I put this switch in and now it's time to solder it. So it is soldered. Now I will cut the remaining. Using the side cutter plier, I am cutting. So it is. Now if I will test on the PCB even, it will do the same way as it was doing outside. You can see it is doing very gently now. I will do for the four later remaining switches, all five switches I will do the same thing, and that I will do off camera, and the result I will show you later on while I will fix it. So hope this will be picked by the camera. Now I'm going to operate these switches. Now I'm going to change the volume. So you can see, here is the volume line. Actually the camera is not picking up it very properly because the rate of the change, I mean to say the raster, this is normally is the case, but you can see this volume line. So it is operating from here. Now the picture, I'm going to check contrast. The contrast is now changing color and brightness, then sharpness, everything is changing. And now I'm going to change the channel also. You will be able to see how the channel is working. Now AV, you can see, and now the channel is coming 1, next is 2, 3, 4 AV, and so on. So this was the repair on this particular sharp television I did. Hope you learned something from this. Thank you for watching. Keep on watching, stay tuned, subscribe and like.